Sorry, Ross. This seems to be good. Can we go right up?
Yeah, just like, my experience, if you work the land, you got to be a jack of all trades. You got to have a little bit of optimism, a little bit of idealism, and a whole lot of get-go.
Thank you. Imagine being able to stream every curling game from every sheet from any event, be it your Wednesday league game, Bondspiel, or corporate event. Curling Stadium offers an all-inclusive streaming solution featuring high-quality cameras, ease of use, great reliability, and minimal installation. Offering your sponsors customizable ad space on your streamed curling games and being able to sell video packages to your corporate events for increased revenue. With Curling Stadium, you can stream to any device, be it your mobile phone, tablet, or computer. Push the feed to your desired platform, be it Facebook, YouTube, or any other social media. Curling Stadium is simply the way forward. Where it's commonplace in other sports to televise every game, we want to do the same. Curling is a global sport, and it's time it gets the coverage it needs. Make your curling club the next curling stadium.
At KIOTI, we know that when the weekend rolls around, you have two choices. Kick up your feet, or kick up some dirt. If only all decisions would be so easy. KIOTI, we dig dirt.
We're for agriculture. For growers. Doers, whatever it takers. We're for doing things with purpose. We're for the little guy with big guy dreams. We're for agriculture. We're for you. Nutrien Ag Solutions, leading the field.
An iron horse leads you north. A wooded canyon draws you in. Where am I?
Okay. Try one more hit roll button, please.
Yeah, find three stone goals on this slide.
Thank you.
back.
Is it under control?
Yeah, sure.
We lost part of our forest to fire several years ago.
We decided to stay and help it recover.
People who have heavy machinery have the opportunity to reach out and help their neighbors for the common good.
When your people are ready, your business is ready. Cintas makes sure they have what they need to perform their best, whether it's freshly laundered work apparel for almost any job imaginable, fire protection systems that are tested and inspected, first aid and safety supplies, floor mats, or cleaning tools and restroom products, stocked and ready when you need them. Better workdays happen together, so visit Cintas.com and get ready for the workday.
We'll be right back.
Thank you. I've been raised on the farm since day one, so I was born into it. My grandfather came in here in 1905. I want to continue the farm for him and generations to come, so.
I think it's a privilege that we get to be here. It's just a wonderful way of life.
You know, what job is there that you can go to work with your dad and brother, with your kids by your side? Doesn't get much better than that.
Thank you. speaking.
Experience, if you work the land, you got to be a jack of all trades. You got to have a little bit of optimism, a little bit of idealism, and a whole lot of get-go.
Okay. Yeah.
Imagine being able to stream every curling game from every sheet from any event, be it your Wednesday league game, bond spiel, or corporate event. Curling Stadium offers an all-inclusive streaming solution featuring high-quality cameras, ease of use, great reliability, and minimal installation. Offering your sponsors customizable ad space on your streamed curling games and being able to sell video packages to your corporate events for increased revenue. With Curling Stadium, you can stream to any device, be it your mobile phone, tablet, or computer. Push the feed to your desired platform, be it Facebook, YouTube, or any other social media. Curling Stadium is simply the way forward. Where it's commonplace in other sports to televise every game, we want to do the same. Curling is a global sport, and it's time it gets the coverage it needs. Make your curling club the next Curling Stadium.
At KIOTI, we know that when the weekend rolls around, you have two choices. Kick up your feet, or kick up some dirt. If only all decisions would be so easy. KIOTI, we dig dirt.
We're for agriculture. For growers, doers, whatever it takers. We're for doing things with purpose. We're for the little guy with big guy dreams. We're for agriculture. We're for you. Nutrien Ag Solutions, leading the field.
An iron horse leads you north. A wooded canyon draws you in. Where am I?
Thank you. I like the freeze place.
Thank you.
seventh inning, lots of rocks to play. Quite the game, that one has been. Okay, we welcome fans to Sheet B at Sioux Curlers Association, the YNCU Curling Center here in Sault Ste. Marie. And we are just wrapped up one semifinal, and we have switched over to this game here. Winner of this will go to the championship game against Team Dunstone from Manitoba. So welcome all those that were watching that game. And maybe the people that were watching the Dunstone Horgan game, you might want to flip over and watch this one now. So turn draw for Joel Retornaz. This is his first shot of the seventh end. Just playing a guard. Looking at the overhead here, it looks like one green. That's Glenn Howard laying one on the button area, surrounded by a bunch of Team Retornaz rocks. One rock each to go here in a well-played game. My name is Al Harnett. I'm here with Juha Cantavera. We bring this broadcast to you this morning. Semi-final action here in Sault Ste. Marie at the Sioux Curlers Association Fall Classic. Been a great event so far. Well attended. Teams have loved it. The fans have been excellent.
Yeah, we got five rocks in the forefoot. Looks like an interesting end of this end. We have three rocks to come. This is Glenn's first rock coming in. They're trying to make a decision on what they're going to do here.
That's right, Juha. They do have two rocks left.
Yep.
Glenn won.
So the green one that's shot, can't really bump that yellow one that's in front of it back and get shot off of it. So it would take two shots, and Retornaz only has one rock left. So I think Glenn. I think Glenn is trying to figure out a way to get a second shot out of this. Might have a little bit of a bump. Might be able to bump that sideways. Looking at a run back.
I wonder if Russ is watching his brother right now.
I don't know.
I can tell you this much. We're not stealing his job.
I don't think he's got a lot of options here. He could try to slither that green one in. Oh, no, there's a rock in front. I just saw that there's a guard guy.
Yeah, he just put that up, you, huh, as we came on air here. When he was throwing it, I thought he was coming right in, but he just threw up that long guard on the outturn side there. So,
yeah, to prevent the double.
Yes. Taking quite a bit of time on this one. It is an important time in the game for sure. These two teams have been going at it every end. Been excellent curling. So it looks like they've settled on trying to drill back this yellow long guard into the pile. See what happens here.
I think he wants to get it right in between the, it's yellow to in between the two green and yellow. Interesting call.
Trying to make some room to get maybe his last one in there. At this point, he can't, so this is hence the call.
trying to get it to curl, but it looks like he's only going to get just a little feather tick on it. Now,
I would say it's probably the same shot, just guarding that side. I don't think there would be any way to get two out of this. Unless, again, he's can drill it back in there and somehow get two.
I don't think so. It looks like a guard.
Yeah.
Long one. I imagine he just wants to drop this over the hog line.
Yeah, it has to stay out there. If he overcurls, Glenn could come around and chip his one over for two.
Sweepers are keeping it out there. Want to make sure it stays as far out as possible.
Yeah, anywhere out there is fine.
Trying to get it a little bit tighter, keeping it straight. No hole, so that's a pretty good shot.
I don't see anything here, but they're looking at.
I don't know how you could promote that. Maybe the yellow come down and punch that green one a little bit toward the center line. I think that's the only shot they've got.
Or a Swedish spinner.
Yeah, that might work too.
That one that he just put there, Juha, I wonder if he could hit that back into that green that's poked out there with just light weight. He doesn't have to move it far. It's a long raise, but...
Yeah, and you don't know what turn it's going to take after you hit it, right?
So it could end badly, too. I mean, right now they're laying one. That means it would be a tie game coming home with the opportunity to put two rocks in the center line that can't be moved with the no-tick rule.
There isn't a lot. There is not a lot of options here. I think those are the only two. Is that long yellow?
So he just tapped that green one. So they are looking at it.
I don't think they can hurt themselves by playing this shot. He's going to try it.
Okay. So he's looking at the other one out front, the green one, all right?
Yeah, playing the green one back.
Onto the yellow. That is at the top of the 12 foot, right between the home and siding. And then into the green and onto the button.
So he needs to get this green rock to the low side of that yellow one.
Yes.
There he goes. Let's see if there's a lot of conviction on this shot.
Out turn. Keeping it straight. It's overcurled.
Nope. It's overcurled. Yeah. Yeah.
So at the end of the seventh end, this game is tied 4-4. We'll be right back with the exciting eighth end to see who the second team goes to the semifinals. Sorry, to the final.
We lost part of our forest to fire several years ago. We decided to stay and help it recover. People who have heavy machinery have the opportunity to reach out and help their neighbors for the common good.
When your people are ready, your business is ready. Cintas makes sure they have what they need to perform their best, whether it's freshly laundered work apparel for almost any job imaginable, fire protection systems that are tested and inspected, first aid and safety supplies, floor mats, or cleaning tools and restroom products, stocked and ready when you need them. Better work days happen together, so visit Cintas.com and get ready for the workday.
And we're back. So Glenn asked for the first rock to be placed as a center guard. It's touching the center line, so it cannot be moved. And Team Retornaz came around that that long guard and just in the top 4 foot behind cover. And they're sweeping this rock to get it to curl, and they've got it on the yellow elk on the corner. And Joel has asked Mattia, I believe is it's pronounced, to put this one on top of that, the green one that was just thrown.
Great having this team here from Italy. We've had a great international flavor to this event. The teams from Europe and Asia, the States.
Good sweep on this one, getting it to curl, getting it right to the face of that rock.
Great angle.
Yep. Glenn's elected to throw another center guard.
So looking at some different options, I think they're happy with the one they have out front, and it's about getting these stones moved around a bit so they get the better angles, and so we'll see what he does here. Again, taking some time. Tim March has come down and join the combo. Want to thank all those in the chat line that are thanking us for the streaming this morning in the semifinal game of the Curlers Fall Classic. Again, if you're in the city, we have a championship game coming in about half an hour, 45 minutes or so. So come on down to the club and enjoy the game live if you wish. The Northern Superior Fan Zone will be open. I notice you have people are getting their seats already for the final.
want to make sure they've got a good spot to see the game.
So out turn draw around the center guard. I think they don't want to move anything here at this point. Trying to make it curl a bit now. These two guys can really sweep. Great brushing.
You got it right in there, right on top of it. And it looks like Joel's going to ask for the peel. I think this is a straight peel. I don't think he wants to run it back into the pile.
No, this will be straight peel for sure. And then you'll probably see guard go up and pattern continue until probably Vice's last rock.
And Glenn saying you can throw it as high as you want, as long as it's over the hog line.
Seem to throw that at the broom.
Sweepers are on it just to keep it clean. Now they're trying to get it to curl a bit. Should finish hard. Great card. Yeah, another straight peel from Sebastiano. And that rock is gone. So another center guard. Again, Glenn wants this up high from Scott.
I guess they'll probably continue with this until maybe Glenn's first one.
I would think so. He's going to have to make a move here somewhere. Yellow shot.
I noticed that the green one that is biting the top forefoot has got kind of an outturn turn to it. So that could be proved to be helpful when if he does choose to go bump. They might have to change those angles up, right? So
no, just a little bit.
But it'll be fun to see.
Straight peel, it's been made.
Okay.
Maybe he's going to do something here on Scott's last rock.
So they've opted to do an in-turn draw and trying to freeze on shot stone in the forefoot. Would make for a good angle.
Definitely doesn't want to roll off that top green one. Wants to get in there.
This is very precise. They make it, it will make for a great finish here. Going to be anyway. That's over curling.
I think it's a little short.
Yeah.
Yeah, they'll take a guard. That's a good miss.
Gonna peel it. They're looking also at the rocks and the rings. If he hits what he could see.
It doesn't look like he can see a lot there.
No. Okay. On the screen, it looks like he can see maybe a quarter at best. If he did hit what he could see, both greens may go.
be very tight. You'll have to squeeze it pretty hard. It's maybe a thin quarter.
Yeah, and if you ever hit a tooth in, you'd be spilling that green one up into the fourth, right up under the butt.
Yep.
After discussion, discretion the better part of valor here, they're just going to peel. Hi to Sue in Michigan. Thanks for watching. Outturn peel.
Just cleaning it. A little bit of a sweep. And it's gone. Glenn's looking at just tapping that yellow one back.
So the reason to tap that back, Yuha, is so it's then lined up, right?
Correct.
Now the fans have been treated to a great game. Been keeping my eye on this one as we're doing the feature game, but there was lots of great shots made every end.
Is that more ice than you had on Scott's last?
No, it's exact. Now it's less. He just took an inch less.
So he's going to be throwing a little bit more weight, obviously.
I guess he can't afford to go deep, right? He's got to touch that yellow up and get that angle. If he does make this, makes Joel's first one a little more dicey for sure. Just cleaning this. This has got late movement on it. You've been watching it.
Yeah. Should curl pretty hard.
It's going now. It's tight to the guard. Think he's by. He is.
Okay. Didn't quite move it enough. I think he'd like to have moved that a little bit further.
Yeah, and the issue with that now is that it came open. It still is lined up a little bit. It would drag in there. But they're looking at hitting that green one that Glenn just put there and rolling inside.
Yeah, if they could get a hit and roll right on top of that yellow one, get in line with it, it would be tough for Glenn to score.
Yeah, there might not even be a shot if he made this perfect. All four guys in the house here. Providing input, they're looking maybe at the top one?
Well, I think they're looking at what Glenn will have on his last one.
Yeah, I think they're going to settle on this one. This is the right call.
I think the hit and roll is the call. Glenn's going to stay something on the green, yellow-green combination coming into the rocks that are going to be left in the forefoot.
intern hit and roll on Joel Retornaz as his first shot here in the eighth end, the semifinal.
Cleaning it. No, sweeping it, keeping it straight. You want a little bit of a roll here? And they did get the roll. A couple shots for Glenn here. He could double those two yellows out and force Joel to either draw to the forefoot or smash those green ones.
That would be a pretty simple shot, you huh?
Yep.
So at this point, I think that yellow one is the helper here. I think they're looking at maybe trying to drag that green one back into the one that's on the button, move it back far enough to get shot.
Yeah, I think if they hit it on the left-hand side, the green one, I think it'll we'll get a little bit of a gear effect there, and I think that green one will come straight back. I think.
So maybe coming down and tapping that on the high side?
Yeah, I think so, with the outturn.
And get the angles. You don't have to move it far.
Well, you got to move that yellow one that's right on the button. You got to move it a rock. A little bit better than a rock. Pretty precise shot.
The conversation continues here in this semifinal game. Just for all of you at home and those that are thinking about coming to watch this afternoon, it was going to be a 12 o'clock start for the final, but we are now bumping that game till 1 o'clock. So everybody out there, the change has been made to for a 1 o'clock final.
But I would still suggest you get here if you want a good seat, get here early. And our team is still trying to make a decision here on what they want to do. It is a critical shot. Retornaz is the shot right on the button. So be interested to see what kind of weight Glenn plays on this shot.
I don't think he can afford to throw much weight here.
No, that's for sure.
There you go. This looks like sort of back circle.
Back circle.
Weight.
Yep.
Trying to get the right angles on that front one. Maybe nose.
I think he needs to be a little bit off. Yeah, maybe nose will do it.
Because that green will squirt a bit. But he's got to have enough weight to move that that yellow one back far enough. Out turn. They're on this.
Right away.
Keeping it straight. It is curling. It does. It looks a little light, eh? They're going at it. Nose is good, I think. Got shot rock out of it, but it is
wide open. They don't want to jam it into the yellow one. I think it's wide open. Let me go take a look.
Pretty much. just edge on edge. It's there.
Might be just a hair buried.
So last rock here to determine who the other finalist is for our 1 o'clock start this afternoon for the championship game.
O-turn hit, wants to make it go away. Doesn't want to jam. Sweepers aren't doing anything, just cleaning it on the way down. It's always good to clean. Looks like the shot's made. There you go. So final score there, that's a three-ender. So final score is 7-4 for Team Retornaz over Team Howard.
Okay.
And we'll be back at 1 o'clock.
Just a note before we go. We've changed it again because we do have a little bit of an issue with one team that needs to get out on their flight. So it'll be 12:30 start. Thank you so much, everyone. We'll see you shortly.
We'll see you at 12:30. I know.
Running the sanctuary absolutely brings me peace. The work is 100% cathartic for me. You know, I find myself getting tied up in it and being busy, and then it's really nice just to sit, breathe in life, and it's beyond zen.
Imagine being able to stream every curling game from every sheet from any event, be it your Wednesday league game, Bonspiel, or corporate event. Curling Stadium offers an all-inclusive streaming solution featuring high-quality cameras, ease of use, great reliability, and minimal installation. Offering your sponsors customizable ad space on your streamed curling games and being able to sell video packages to your corporate events for increased revenue. With Curling Stadium, you can stream to any device, be it your mobile phone, tablet, or computer. Push the feed to your desired platform, be it Facebook, YouTube, or any other social media. Curling Stadium is simply the way forward. Where it's commonplace in other sports to televise every game, we want to do the same. Curling is a global sport, and it's time it gets the coverage it needs. Make your curling club the next Curling Stadium.